Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, accompanied by his bodyguard, Virgil. We've seen in the past weeks the making of the Million Dollar Belt. This week, we want to see it.
You know, Uncle Lynn, since my first day in the World Wrestling Federation, I told you and everybody else that there wasn't anybody or anything that I couldn't buy, including the World Wrestling Federation Championship. And when I said that, everybody laughed. They scoffed and said, that's impossible. Buy the championship. But when Andre the Giant defeated Hulk Hogan, was awarded the belt and handed it over to me, I left egg on the face of the top brass of the World Wrestling Federation. I embarrassed them. I humiliated them because I did what I said I would do. And what did they do? They came up with some bogus rule to save face, and they stripped me of the belt. Well, I've had time to think about that. And what they did, Okerlund, is they did me a favor. Because you see, the World Wrestling Federation Championship is not worthy to go around the waist of the Million Dollar Man. It does not denote enough class or athletic ability to go around this waist. But what I have right here under this jacket is worth $1 million.
Wow. Let's see it.
Take a look.
Oh, my word.
Look at that.
The Million Dollar Belt.
Oh, Virgil.
Look at that.
Let everybody see the Million Dollar Belt.
I can't believe it.
Right there is solid gold and diamonds.
That is gorgeous.
The most precious stones, the highest quality stones, and fashioned by the best jeweler in this country. And it's worth $1 million. Oh. Feel it, Okerlund. Feel the weight of that gold. Take a look at that, yeah.
I am impressed. That's heavy.
Get your grubby hands off of that.
I was just going to inspect it. You didn't even give me a chance.
Yes,
nobody
take a look at it.
Touches the Million Dollar Belt unless I give them permission to. And certainly nobody will ever wear the Million Dollar Belt because there's not a wrestler or a human being in this world with enough class or worthy of wearing this belt or capable of taking it from me.
What about Brutus the Barber
Beefcake? Brutus Beefcake, I wouldn't let you cut the hair on my dog, let alone touch a hair on my head. And you've got to be a total idiot to think you'll ever get the opportunity to take this belt off of me. And WrestleMania 5, what a more perfect place to put this belt on display. A town, Atlantic City, where money and wealth is what it's all about and where I belong.
I thank you, the Million Dollar Belt and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.